He's a worldwide number one best-selling author and winner of numerous awards, including an OBE for services to literature. His crime thriller series, also known as Tartan Noir, on Inspector Rebus, has just celebrated its 30-year anniversary with his latest instalment, Rather Be the Devil. To tell us more, please welcome to the cafe, Ian Rankin.
Yes, nice.
It's funny because I think every single household that I visit, and mine included, has an Ian Rankin book somewhere on the bookshelves. I mean, 20 million books you've sold. That's extraordinary. But you still feel sometimes like you're a bit of a fake.
Yeah. I mean, as a writer, you're always afraid you're going to get found out this time, that you've been kind of riding your luck for a long time. You know, I mean, when I started out, I didn't know this. You know, I was a student when I wrote the first one. And I thought that was only going to be it. And the first draft of the first Rebus novel, he died at the end.
Oh.
He was shot and killed.
I'm glad you didn't do that.
Well, yeah. For some reason, I went back in the second draft and decided he would live. So that was a lucky call.
What made you, Ian, pick up a pen or a typewriter and start writing a book? What was it?
You know, right from the get-go, when I was a small child, you know, I mean, all kids have got this, we all had it, this really active imagination, this fantasy world you would live in. And I just drew it and I wrote it on paper. So I'd do cartoons and try to do comics. And eventually it was pop lyrics because I wasn't in a band. I had no skill. So I invented the band in my head. Those song lyrics became poems. The poems were telling stories. So I started writing short stories. The stories got longer. Mm. So it's a very organic process for me.
And then,
but the thing about writing is you can start at any age.
Good.
You can start in your 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, and you can still make it.
Well,
and what
you
do you make about a buck off a book, 20 million books, so you know. See what it is?
Yeah. Well, there's various cuts in there as well. Agents and lawyers.
And you've still got to be good, I guess.
And now, for those people who may not have picked up an Inspector Rebus book, tell us a little bit about him and what's the story.
Well, he works out of Edinburgh in Scotland. I wasn't born and brought up there, but I went there to go to university and I wanted to try and make sense of the place. So I started writing about it. And I thought a cop is a pretty good way of looking at a society from top to bottom because he's got access to everybody. So he became very useful as a way of looking at Scottish society and also taking on big moral questions. Crime fiction says to all of us, why do we human beings keep doing terrible things? And Edinburgh's a city that on the surface when you visit it, like a lot of cities in New Zealand, looks great, looks ordered, you know, there's museums and art galleries and everybody seems to be having fun sitting in cafes and bars. You scratch the surface, bad things are happening. And they're just hidden below the surface.
That's absolutely right. And you say also that you write books with sort of hidden meanings in them sometimes. Did you write a book where your friend actually had to tell you what it was about? Like you wrote an Inspector Rebus book and he went, oh, that's actually about your boys leaving home.
Yeah. I mean, I think as a writer, you don't always know why you're doing what you're doing. And I mean, to me, that was a book about a plot. And then my friend said, well, hang on a minute, there's all these father-son relationships in it. It's actually about your sons having grown up and having left home and you wondering, did you do the best you could do? Would you change anything?
That's the empty nest syndrome in a book.
Absolutely.
And you write the characters in real time. So what made you choose to do it that way?
Well, I thought, how can you talk about the way that a city's changing or a country's changing or a culture or politics is changing if the main character never changes?
Right.
So I thought he's going to live, and I didn't, if I thought in the early days, I would have thought, no, don't do that, because eventually he'll have to retire, you know, or make him younger in book one. So there came a point where he had to retire in real life, and so he did. So now I've got the added, well, it's a challenge, but a challenge is good. So you think, okay, he's retired. How can I get him involved in a police investigation? What can he do that he couldn't do before? What can't he do now that he could do before? So in the latest book, for example, he pretends to be a police officer.
Right.
He nicks some business cards from a cop, and he can just hand them out pretending he's that cop.
I love it.
So how do you do the research for these books? Because obviously,
hanging
police
around
work.
Bars a lot.
Yeah, police bars. What's that you say?
Absolutely. That's
changing.
Exactly right, though. I mean, there was one book that was, you know, I'd been going to a lot of retirement parties, police retirement parties, and I would go along and I'd listen to all these great stories, and I would excuse myself, go to the bathroom, type it into my phone, go back out again. Sorry. Can you just give me that again? And I've just got to go to the bathroom again. I thought, what's this guy got, a prostate problem? And it was just, but all the anecdotes I got made a whole novel. I got a whole novel out of it. So yeah, I mean, people tell me stories. People write to me and say, have you thought about this? There's stuff in the newspapers all the time. Even in New Zealand, I'm clipping newspaper stories and taking them home with me, thinking I might get something out of that.
So Inspector Rebus might come to New Zealand at some
stage in the
future?
I doubt it. He's not got a passport.
Bit of a trip.
He's not got a passport.
Right.
But his colleagues, Siobhan Clark and Malcolm Fox, could. People have said to me, yeah, they could. If it's a Scots person on vacation in New Zealand and they die in mysterious circumstances, the cops will arrive from Scotland to check everything's okay. So there you go.
Nice to get you here for the Writers Festival, aren't you?
Auckland Writers Festival.
Is it your first time here in New Zealand?
It's not my first time in New Zealand. It's not my first time in Auckland, but it's my first time at the Auckland Writers Festival.
Nice.
And I'm starting to go through the programme going, this is huge.
Yeah.
So there's so many people I want to go and see. So I don't know how I'm going to find time to see the rest of the city.
Oh, you'll make time sometime. It's been an absolute pleasure
having
you in the
studio. Hasn't it? Yes. Most famous writer I've ever met, actually.
So
there you go.
So far.
Yeah, so far.
Nice week. Now, you can get a copy of Rather Be the Devil from all good bookstores right now. And if you'd like to hear more from Ian, head along to An Evening with Ian Rankin, hosted by Mark Sainsbury, tonight or on Sunday as part of the Auckland Writers Festival. Check out the website for details.